Hey there, content creators! In today's video, we are going to talk about the Sprite tool in VSDC Free Video Editor. We will explore what this tool is, how to create it, how to work with it, which settings you can apply, and some important changes introduced in VSDC 8.3. If you haven't yet upgraded to VSDC 8.3, you can find the link for downloading in the description. So let's jump right in. Before we begin, launch the program and start a new project. But wait, first, what is a sprite? Well, a sprite is a kind of a container with files inside. It can be non-transparent, fully transparent, or nested with effects. A sprite helps you organize, group, and stack elements into one sprite, and then work with this group of elements as a single entity. Now, let's create a sprite. You can do it in several ways. The first option is to use the Objects tool panel on the left side of the scene. Look for the Add Sprite button. It looks like a blue rectangle with a red one beneath it. Clicking on it will prompt the program to ask where you want to create the sprite and specify its duration. In this example, we will choose whole parent duration to create a sprite from the beginning to 10 seconds, and then draw an arbitrary rectangle on the scene. You can adjust its size to match the scene size by going to the sprite's properties and selecting Set the same size as the parent has. There is an alternative way to create a sprite using the Add Object button in the Editor tab on the ribbon panel, which is similar to the one in the Objects tool panel. You can also use the hotkey Shift-P to quickly activate the tool. However, if you have already created any objects, you can merge them into a sprite. So let's create two rectangles. After selecting them, simply right-click and choose Convert to Sprite from the drop-down menu. You'll have two sprite options differing only in size. The first option creates a sprite within object's resolution, while the second matches the scene resolution. Let's select the first option. Next, let's create two more rectangles and select them. This time, we'll create a different type of sprite within the scene resolution. Click on it twice to access its content, then add the Transform Distort effect. In the Effect properties, choose Wave from the Type field. Don't be concerned if you don't see any changes on the scene. This is because the sprite has a property to hide effects. Now let's go back to Scene 0, select the sprite, and in its properties set User's Container to No. This will make the distortion effect visible. However, if we go inside the sprite, there are still no effects because the sprite's property hides effects. This property is useful if you need to quickly disable all effects inside the sprite. In our case, set Show Effects to Yes in the sprite's properties, and when you go inside the sprite, the effect is now visible. You might have noticed that our background has turned black. This happened because the sprite's default brush property filled the background with black color. But we want a transparent background. To achieve this, choose Transparent instead of Solid in the brush properties. Now that you can see all the rectangles, let's duplicate the distort effect to the second sprite and set User's Container to No, Show Effects to Yes, and Brush to Transparent for the second sprite as well. As you can see, the distort effect got cut off at the edges of the second sprite because this sprite was created to match the dimensions of the rectangles. To avoid this, we added the option to convert to sprite within the scene resolution in VSDC 8.3. This will help prevent an error while creating the sprite. But if this happens anyway and the effects are cropped, just double-click the sprite, go to the Properties window, and click the Set the same size as the parent has option. The next option is Apply Echo Filter. We've got a separate tutorial on it, which you can watch by clicking on the link at the top of the screen. But now we would like to give you a more detailed description of this option using another example. So let's see how the echo filter works in sprites and create motion for the rectangle using the movement tool. To do this, hide one rectangle and go inside the other one. Click on Add Movement in the Objects tool panel in the left vertical bar and then click OK and specify the endpoint where it should move to. Next, shorten the animation to 2 seconds by moving the yellow marker at the end of the timeline to the 2-second point. This creates a cool wave motion. Now, let's return to Scene 0, select the sprite, and move on to the remaining properties. The first one, apply Echo Filter, adds a default motion blur effect, which is initially turned off. Let's enable it and play the animation. You'll see a fantastic motion effect. Let's dive into how it works. In the Echo Strength field, by setting it to, for example, 100, we get an effect where all frames are preserved as the object moves. The lower the value of this parameter, the faster the trail disappears behind the moving object. Let's set it to 10, for example. In addition, you can set keyframes for this parameter, create a linear change by expanding this parameter and specifying the initial and final values, or by using the curve editor, opening it with 3 points. And the last parameter is the frame overlay type. Overlay is a default setting. Let's set it to streak. It will make our motion smoother. Let's set the parameter to 90. Let's set the value to 100 and the result is quite distinct. There are no longer those bars that we saw in overlay. The final mode for today is blur. Let's set it for the sprite within a value of 100. That way we get a slightly different effect now. The wave is moving and it reveals the edges it passes through. Now let's set the parameter to 50. Over time, the edges begin to disappear, creating a different effect. What you see on the screen shows how the motion looks with different settings for this effect. We hope that this will help you if you ever need to add a smoothing effect. There is one more important sprite parameter left, the stretching of effects and objects within it. This parameter is actually available for all elements, but it is more commonly used when working with sprites. To see how it works, let's go to the scene 0 again and stretch the sprite. By default, the value is set so that the objects within the sprite do not change their duration, and as a result, there won't be a wave displayed at the end of the sprite. If you want the objects inside the sprite to stretch or compress to the new duration, you need to set the Lock to Parent Duration value to Yes in the properties of the objects within the sprite under the Objects Drawing Duration section. Now, when you change the sprite's duration, the length of the objects will adjust to the new duration. That's all for today. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments. And don't forget to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. See you next time!